corruption reigns here, I'm sure of it. The number of people injured by the machine cannot be calculated.
About the reports. Your masters won't be happy if their accounts go up in smoke.
Mother of God, you're right. Follow me, quickly. some time to explain.
Not this way.
They should be just inside here. Oh, there they are. Good. They're safe.
Oi! What do you think you're doing? Stop, thief!
Shoot!
Like that time for you, Piggy! Ready to fire?
Stay rooted to that spot.
I'm with you.
Follow me. We're finished here.
On your way!
Get up!
Fred, I'm sorry to be so blunt, but I need to ask a favor of you. A delivery awaits me at the docks, a very rare orchid, all the way from the island of Madagascar. I need you to collect it for me first. Thank you, my young friend, thank you. This little orchid may seem inconsequential, but it holds secrets which could potentially change our very understanding of the world. It would have been a shame to lose it. A shame indeed. Thank you.
break.
What can you do?
Champagne Charlie is my name. Good for any game at night.
Roses for love, lilies for fine. Little sweet. I'll
our friend Frank Morris. His son dropped dead of exhaustion after finishing an 18-hour shift. He is consumed by time.
Bloody perfect. Best deal with this before Morris shows up.
Tell Mark that I don't need his help. All yours! What do you expect me to do? Even a dog will bite if kicked once too often. I don't like being told.
Easy, girl. Easy.
That's the way.
Turn right!
Whoa, easy! Let's go. All together now.
Turn right!
Slow down now! Doing fine, girl. Walk on, girl. Whoa, now! Steady on.
Up there! Who are these people?
People who don't like you stealing their toys.
We're trapped in here unless you ascend and deal with them. Let's have a salvo!
Throw everything off!
Let me out the ladder!
Nitro back. That must please you.
Not even close. You knew where to find that cart. You must have been tracking shipments for weeks. Tell me where that supply was headed.
I might be able to assist you. Find me in Southwark when you're ready.
Ah, my dear Darwin, do you think our young friend here, equipped with a multiplicity of talents...
Mr. John Hammond?
That is correct.
Jacob Fry, Mr. Dickens sent me to meet you.
Oh, good old Dickens. How very kind of him. Lead on, then.
Mr. Fry, good to see you again, sir.
London. Can't say I've missed the weather. My father passed away recently, and I have come home to settle his affairs. Also, I am to be married.
What's that thing?
Hand over your money. I just can't talk.
I can put it on.
Serves you bloody well right.
Good work. How exciting. This is like something out of a novel.
Won't bite back now, will you?
That's the way. Bring fire to
him.
Fiancée. I can't wait to see her response. I feel quite liberated, as if a great weight has been lifted from my shoulders. After this, just to be sure, would you take me to my fiancée's house? I shall deliver the sad news myself.
Seems a bit risky to me.
She has never set eyes on me. Besides, I need to ascertain whether I like her as well. And I want to see how she reacts to the news of my death. Come on, hurry up! This is taking far too long. Going the wrong way, I'm sure of it. Please hurry, I'm very anxious to meet Miss Wilson.
Walk on, girl. Steady on.
Clear the way.
Keep moving.
Clear the way. Make five rod them loose.
Hey.
Easy, girl. Easy.
Excellent. Now let us go and meet my fiancé. I can't wait to see her response. I feel quite liberated, as if a great weight has been lifted from my shoulders. After this, just to be sure, would you take me to my fiancé's house? I shall deliver the sad news myself.
Seems a bit risky to me.
She has never set eyes on me. Besides, I need to ascertain whether I like her as well. And I want to see how she reacts to the news of my death.
You are.
Yes? Yes?
My name is John Rokesmith. I'm afraid I have some terrible news for you.
Oh?
Your fiancé, John Hammond, was found dead in the River Thames this morning.
Oh, how awful! Poor Mr. Hammond. I am at a loss at what to say to you, sir. You must forgive me.
She is delightful. Why, I do believe I love her.
Certainly an unusual first meeting to talk about in your wedding speech.
Remember that young lady I was engaged to marry before I feigned my death so that I could see what sort of woman she was? I'm now in love with her and I want to marry her after all. And I need you. I have a rather artful plan. You, playing the part of a ruffian, will kidnap her. Then you must bring her to where I am waiting. I shall leap from a shadowy corner and beat you to a pulp, thereby saving her life and winning her heart.
That is far and away, beyond the shadow of a doubt, the worst plan I have ever heard.
Now, put me down somewhere insalubrious, and I shall ready an ambush for you. Somewhere in Lambeth should suffice.
Easy does it.
This'll do.
That's the way.
Enough. Off you go and nab her. She's at Waterloo Station, I believe. Oh, and make
that's
sure
a girl.
You play your part well.
Doing fine.
Easy now.
Walk on, girl. Keep moving. Easy, girl. Easy. Who's a good horse? You are. Let's go. Whoa, easy. I'm abducting you for a friend. No, that still sounds terrible.
Unhand me this instant! We make for a peculiar pair. You'll be found out in no time. What is the meaning of this?
No good will come of that.
Is there nothing I can say to make you release me? This is terribly inappropriate. For a peculiar pair, you'll be found out in no time.
What's the matter?
Should I be concerned with what's happening?
Is there nothing I can say to make you release me?
What are these fuckers up to?
I don't like the sound of that.
Is something happening?
Hey, Magnolias, grieving a lost love.
Don't
friend. No, that's still some stuff.
Calm, everyone. The situation is in
it. Oh, no. Do you think they died very horribly?
Isn't this exciting?
You're coming with me, little bird.
Oh! Stop! Help!
I shall save you, madam, for I am John Hammond, your fiancé.
What?
En garde!
Suspicious.
I say! This is cold! Take this, you rogue! Clearly, I am your better. Take this, you rogue. Take your punishment. Clearly, I am your better. Take this, you rogue. Take your punishment. Clearly, I am your better.
A ruse? I suspect.
Take this, you. I shall save you, madam, for I am John Hammond, your fiancé.
What?
Oh, girl! Take this, you rogue! I say, this is getting a little too real.
Can someone explain what is happening?
Take your punishment. Ha! Clearly, I am better. Take this, you rogue.
You're done for.
From the beginning.
I shall save you, madam, for I am John Hammond, your fiancé.
What?
En garde! I say, this is getting a little too real. Take this, you rogue!
Suspicious.
Take your punishment! Clearly, I am better. Take this, you rogue!
Can you explain what is happening?
I'm on you, mate! Run!
Take your punishment!
I shall save you, madam, for I am John Hammond, your fiancé.
What?
On guard!
Take this, you rogue! Take your punishment!
This is all
clearly, I am better! Take this, you rogue! Take your punishment! Clearly, I am better! Take this, you rogue! Take your punishment! Clearly, I am better!
What? A ruse? I suspected as much from the beginning.
I shall save you, madam, for I am John Hammond, your fiancé.
What?
On guard! Take this, you rogue! Take your punishment! Ha! Clearly, I am you! Take this, you rogue! Take your punishment! Ha! Clearly, I am your master. Take this, you rogue! Take your punishment! Ha! Clearly, I am your master. Take this, you rogue! Take your punishment!
What a happy coincidence that you were here to save me!
Wasn't it? And if you will allow me, my dearest Bella, I shall forever be by your side to protect you from this day forth. Come, my dear, let us be gone from this terrible place, and I shall explain all.
I should return to Charlie and Charlie to tell them the happy news.
Yes.
And so all's well that ends well. Our young lovers are united at last and will soon marry.
No accounting for taste, I suppose.
And by the looks of you, they really hit it off.
I must say, it's all rather exciting. I do love these sorts of tales.
It all feels strangely familiar. I wonder why. We should drink to John Hammond and his unconventional idea of courtship.
Indeed. To John Hammond, our mutual friend.
They're moving the shipment, but we must go now. There's a carriage on the next corner. If we hide within, they'll drive us right to it.
I'll hide. These ones get to live, at least until they drive me to this factory.
Time? What the hell took you so long?
Yeah, I'd like to see anyone try and break in here.
I'm sorry, but my need is greater than you know. Justice will be done.
Wait, don't...
Morris! Poor sod.
All right. Better smash these crates before anyone else gets any bright ideas.
Thank you.
did he come from?
Thank you.
I see. I was afraid it would come to this. He was a good man, but even the best of us can lose our way when blinded by grief. Still, I thank you for preventing a greater tragedy.
We'll be feasting tonight, we will.
All right.
Head shot, chief.
Not bad.
Huh?
I'm so relieved to have found you. I fear my upcoming meeting is going to be disrupted. Strikebreakers, maybe. Or spies. Ruffians who fear the march of progress.
Ah! So I'm bodyguarding them. Marvelous.
I worry that any agitation will incite terrible violence, so please remove troublemakers without attracting any attention. Wunderbar. Thank you. I must prepare, but I will see you inside shortly.
Ladies and gentlemen, United Workers! The man we're here to see needs no introduction, but I shall give him one anyway. He has sacrificed so much in the hope that we may all benefit. Please give a warm reception to Mr. Karl Marx.
Brothers, comrades, thank you for your most generous welcome. I come before you today with a heavy heart.
You know
England stands at the top of commercial and industrial Europe.
Get lost!
In the last 2 decades, there has been a... generous welcome. I come before you today with a heavy heart. England stands at the head of commercial and industrial Europe. In the last 2 decades, there has been an unheard of development of industry and unprecedented increase in exports and imports. While these are facts to be celebrated by the working classes, for the workers, very little has changed. You well know under what conditions of shattered health, damaged morals, and spiritual ruin this increase of wealth and power was produced for the upper classes by the working class. It has become a truth that no perfecting of machinery, no application of science to industry, no improvement of the means of communication, no new colonies, no emigration, no opening out of new markets, no free trade, and not all these things put together can do away with the misery of the toiling masses. But rather, on the contrary, that upon the present false basis, every new development of the productive power of labor must lead to the widening of the gulf between the classes and to the heightening of social antagonisms. During this epoch of economic progress, death from starvation has raised itself almost to the rank of a social institution here in London, the capital of the British Empire. In the annals of world history, this age will be characterized by the more impetuous course, the more expanded range, and the deadlier effects of the social plague known as the commercial and industrial crisis. I believe that it is not necessary that the means of labor should be monopolized as a means of dominating the workers and exploiting them.
We're fast friends now, aren't we?
So also wage labor is only a transitory subordinate social form which is destined to vanish before associated labor. With willing hands, vigorous mind, and cheerful heart, it has been said that the House of Commons is a house of landlords. I wish to you today that to capture political power is now the great duty of the working class. We must attempt the political reorganization of the workers if we are to improve their lot. The workers must go forward in a united fashion with the simultaneous demand that the simple laws of morality and justice which are considered right in the relations of private persons, shall be recognized as the supreme law governing labor in this country. The struggle for such a policy is embraced in the universal struggle for the emancipation of the working class. And so I say to you, proletarians of all lands, unite! In order to free the workers, the cooperative system of labor requires to develop on a national scale. And following from that, must be furthered by national means. For their part, the lords of the land and the lords of capital will continue steadily to use their political privileges for the defense and perpetuation of their monopoly. Instead of furthering the emancipation of the workers, they will act so as to bring every possible obstacle in the way.
For your most generous welcome. I come before you today with a heavy heart. England stands at the head of commercial and industrial Europe. In the last two decades, there has been an unheard-of development of industry and unprecedented increase in exports and imports. While these are facts to be celebrated by the property classes, for the workers, very little has changed. Health, damaged morals, and spiritual ruin, this increase of wealth and power was produced for the upper classes by the working class. It has become a truth that no perfecting of machinery, no application of science to industry, no improvement of the means of communication, no new colonies, no immigration, no opening out of new markets, no free trade, and no the widening of the gulf between the classes and to the heightening of social antagonisms. During this epoch of economic progress, death from starvation has raised itself almost to the rank of a social institution here in London, the capital of the British Empire. In the annals of world history, this age will be characterized by the more impetuous course, the more expanded range, and the deadlier effects of the social plague known as the commercial and industrial crisis. I believe that it is not necessary that the means of labor should be monopolized as a means of dominating the workers and exploiting them. That just like slavery and serfdom, so also wage labor is only a transitory subordinate social form which is destined to vanish before associated labor, which will accomplish its work with willing hands, vigorous mind, and cheerful heart. It has been said that the House of Commons is a house of landlords. Please give a warm reception to Mr. Karl Marx.
workers, comrades, thank you for your most generous welcome. I come before you today with a heavy heart. England stands at the head of commercial and industrial Europe. In the last two decades, there has been an unheard-of development of industry and unprecedented increase in exports and imports. While these are facts to be celebrated by the propertied classes, for the workers, very little has changed. You well know under what conditions of shattered health.
Never did play on the right side, did ya? Thank you.
Saga. Owe me a tanner.
A great service for the workers of London. I'm confident the reforms we seek cannot be far over the horizon. I don't suppose you'd formally join the Workers' Party.
I'm not much for politics.
He's not much for anything that requires deep thought.
Does that mean you'll join, Comrade Evie?
I'm afraid I have other responsibilities.
Honorary memberships, perhaps.
You don't give up, do you?
We seem to have that in common. Auf Wiedersehen, my friends.
Oh, Jacob, Evie, it's you. Thank goodness.
Experimenting, are we, Alec?
Correct.
And looking a bit frazzled.
Nerves. It's those great oafs Static keeps sending round to coax me. He is offering a ridiculous amount of money.
Alec, you're not thinking of jumping ship, are you?
Never.
I've been working in something, in case they get too insistent.
It's meant to stun an assailant, should the need arise.
Are you certain that it works?
Not as such. I've made three of them with varying degrees of acidity and whatnot. Oh, one must be the right formula.
Let's find some Staric lackeys to target then, shall we?
Speaking of Staric, he is still transmitting false information.
We could simply destroy his transmitters.
His company's too well guarded. The bombs will help, but it would be awkward to produce bombs that potentially do not stun. Oh, wait a minute. Looks like opportunity has come knocking. Oh dear, they never looked so angry before.
Stand clear, Alec.
Let us instead play a little linguistic game with them. Take the bombs and climb onto the roof. When I see the name of a fruit, toss one near the thugs.
Right then.
I nearly forgot. Slip these into your boots and you will henceforth be immune to all voltaic discharge. I think.
Gentlemen, I would ask you in for tea, but I'm afraid I'm running rather late.
Enough of the niceties. We've come to smash your place up, ain't we, Bess?
You got one of them telly what's it in here, ain't ya? You've been reading messages from the Staric Company.
That is as untrue as the notion that the Staric Telegraph Company is emitting impartial information, sir.
Come again?
Your employer's promises are nothing but hot air. His operations are about to turn pear-shaped.
What you going on about air and pears, huh?
Oh, I don't know, I feel rough.
I worried you had the mental agility of a dollop of donkey's apples.
Apples?
I think he's trying to be funny.
Oh, dropped another one, Bill. You little sod.
Ain't me, guys. Oh, blimey, it's got me
through. Oh, those rascals throwing stink bombs again. It happens all the time around here.
Right. Tell us where you keep that telly what's it. I'll count to three.
Three? Well, well. Let's see how far you get.
One.
Do you really think I would keep it here? Do you see a cable? A telegraph without a cable is about as useful as a bell without a clapper.
I'll give you a bleeding clapper.
Well, bless my boots, you're as purple as a plum.
A plum?
I feel all wobbly, Baz.
You are in trouble, my dear fellow.
I'm with you!
Yeah. Bravo, Alec.
Thanks to you, Jacob. Your mere presence gave me courage and resolve I never knew I had.
I found myself rather witty too.
Well, make some more bombs and let's sort out Staric's propaganda machine, shall we?
Yeah.
on, we haven't got all day.
The longer we can keep Starek from spewing out false information, the more we can awaken the people with the truth about his operations.
Let's get to it, then.
Would you believe my mother says there are still some wives in her street that swear by that soothing salve? So I took it upon myself to tell her neighbours the truth about the obnoxious draft.
Good on you, Alan. But you can't go knocking on everyone's door.
No, I wasn't always welcome. It shows how false information can be as difficult to stamp out as fishwives' profanities at Billingsgate.
Or rats in the sewers.
But if we can eradicate a source that continually feeds such detrimental trash, then little by little the truth will take the upper hand and the sham will be flushed out.
Let's crack on, then. Here we are.
We will have to get in without being detected, mate.
While I stun them, you sneak inside.
I shall destroy not one, but three parts of the transmitter. He'll be as good as dancing before a public toilet without a penny.
Anything of interest?
Just set me up.
I say, this is becoming rather perilous, to say the least.
Pistols at the ready! Fire!
Not end well. Oh, gosh, I failed that.
Please, that's it!
Hard fiddly, that one. But I've pulled it as well as a dentist pulls a rotten tooth. There.
Move on to the next part, Alec.
It is a door nail. I say, this is becoming rather perilous, to say the least.
As a dentist pulls a rotten tooth. There.
Move on to the next part, Hallie.
Draw and shoot!
Dears, Jacob, Evie, thanks are once again in order for supporting what is most dear to me and to our cause, freedom of speech.
It's a blessing that you employ your genius for the common good, Alec.
However, I suggest you vacate your workshop.
No need. Not now. You've given me sacks full of courage. And besides, what with my little devices, I have all the protection I need. Should you find yourselves with a moment to spare, do drop by.
Thank you.
hijackings, raids, robberies. So much variety.